morning students. Today we are going to discuss about the internal iliac artery. Blood vessels of pelvis. There are three sets of arteries encountered in the lesser pelvis. An unpaired median sacral artery, this one. And an unpaired superior rectal artery, and then paired internal iliac artery. This is the internal iliac artery. So paired internal iliac arteries, unpaired median sacral, and unpaired superior rectal arteries. So internal iliac artery, it is also called as the hypogastric artery. And along with these three arteries, in addition, a pair of ovarian arteries are seen in the females, which are derived from the abdominal aorta and enters the pelvic cavity through the suspensory ligament of ovary and anastomose with the uterine branches of the internal iliac arteries. So that image I'll show you in the next slides. So along with these three, ovarian arteries are present in the females. And coming to the median sacral artery, so it arises from the dorsal surface of the abdominal aorta. So here the abdominal, this is the common iliac here, this is the abdominal aorta. So from the dorsal surface of the abdominal aorta, this is the median sacral artery. Okay, so it arises from the dorsal surface of the abdominal aorta just above the aortic bifurcation. This is the aortic bifurcation into two common iliac arteries. So just above this bifurcation from the dorsal surface, there is origin of the median sacral artery. And the artery passes downwards in front of the, so this one, this is passing downwards in front of the body of fifth lumbar vertebra here, and along the midline of the pelvic surface of sacrum and coccyx, right? And in its course, it supplies the back of rectum here. So this is the dorsal side of the rectum. So it supplies the back of rectum and the tissues in the post-rectal space, and also provides spinal branches which enter the pelvic sacral foramen. So pelvic sacral foramen here, these are the sacral foramen. So this also provides some spinal branches which enter the pelvic sacral foramen and supply the contents of the sacral canal. And the artery terminates in the near this coccygeus, which contains numerous arteriovenous anastomoses. Here there will be numerous arteriovenous anastomoses here, so it terminates near the coccyx. So that is about the median sacral artery. Then coming to the superior rectal artery, this is the superior rectal artery, and here in this image, if we see, this one is the superior rectal artery. So this superior rectal artery, it is a continuation of the inferior mesenteric artery and enters the pelvic cavity. This is the inferior mesenteric artery, right? So the continuation of the inferior mesenteric artery is the superior rectal artery here, and it enters the pelvic cavity by crossing the front of the left common iliac vessel. So this is the left common iliac artery, and there will be left common iliac vein. So crossing them, it is entering into the pelvis, and it passes obliquely downward along the descending limb of root of sigmoid colon here. This is the descending limb of root of sigmoid colon. Okay, and then it divides into two lateral branches at the rectosigmoid junction. This divides, the superior rectal divides into two lateral branches at the rectosigmoid junction, and this is the superior rectal artery is the principal artery of the rectum, principal arterial supply of the rectum, right? Then we'll go to the internal iliac artery. Each artery arises, this is the internal iliac artery and this is the external iliac artery on the left side. So this internal iliac artery arises from the common iliac artery opposite the lumbosacral disc. This is the lumbar vertebra and this is the sacrum. So opposite the lumbosacral disc, it takes origin in front of the sacroiliac joint. Here this is the sacroiliac joint. This is the sacrum and the ilium. So sacroiliac joint opposite the sacro, in front of the sacroiliac joint. So the relations we can say opposite the lumbosacral disc and in front of the sacroiliac joint, that is where the artery is taking its origin. And it consists of a trunk. This is the trunk. So this trunk is approximately around 4 centimeters long. Okay, and this trunk is 4 centimeters long. And then it divides into an anterior division, which is the continuation of the main artery, anterior division, and a posterior division, right? So this is the posterior division and this is the anterior division. So the arterial trunk passes subperitoneally downwards in front of the sacroiliac joint, here in front of the sacroiliac joint, and on reaching the upper margin of greater sciatic foramen, okay, this one, this is the greater sciatic foramen into which the piriformis is going. This is the piriformis muscle, okay. So here this is the greater sciatic foramen, and reaching the upper border, this is the upper border of the greater sciatic foramen. So at this level, it is dividing into an anterior and a posterior division. And the anterior division is the continuation of the trunk, and it continues up to the ischial spine. This is the ischial spine here. So this anterior division continues till the ischial spine, and posterior division, it passes downwards and backward, okay, and downward in the region of the greater sciatic foramen. So this is the greater sciatic foramen. So posterior trunk is running downwards and backwards in this region, whereas anterior division is reaching the ischial spine, right? So this is about the internal iliac artery. Then we'll see the relations and branches of the internal iliac artery in the next slides. Right, the relations, if we see in front, so this is the internal iliac artery, right? So in front of the internal iliac artery, the pelvic part of the ureter is related to the internal iliac artery, and in females it forms the posterior boundary of ovarian fossa. So in this image, if we see, this is the ovary here, and this is the suspensory ligament of the uterine tube, and this is the ovary. So the ovary is situated in the ovarian fossa. So ovarian fossa, here if we see, it is related to inferiorly obturator nerve and obturator vessels are seen, and superiorly external iliac vessels are seen. Laterally, we'll see the this one, internal iliac. Posteriorly, we'll see the internal iliac artery and the ureter here. So these are the boundaries of the ovarian fossa. So here if we see, this is the internal iliac artery and ureter forming the posterior boundary of the ovarian fossa, okay, this one. And so that is the relation in front. Behind or back side, we'll see the internal iliac vein here. This is the internal iliac vein, and this one is the lumbosacral trunk and sacroiliac joint here. Right, from before backwards, the posterior relations of the artery are internal iliac vein, lumbosacral trunk, and sacroiliac joint. Right, then laterally, the medial border of the psoas major is not shown in this image. So here laterally, we'll see the medial border of psoas major and external iliac vein. This is the external iliac vein and obturator nerve. This is the obturator nerve, and this is the obturator artery. So laterally we are seeing the medial border of psoas major, external iliac vein and obturator nerve, and medially covered by peritoneum. The artery is covered by peritoneum and crossed by terminal part of the ileum on the right side, and by the sigmoid colon and its mesocolon on the left side. So that is not seen in this image. So medially, terminal part of ileum on the right side and sigmoid colon with its mesocolon on the left side. So these are the relations of the internal iliac artery. So now coming to the branches of the internal iliac artery, the branches we are going to divide into branches coming from the anterior division and branches coming from the posterior division. So the branches coming from the anterior division, the first one is the obliterated this one, obliterated umbilical artery is this one. Then here this is the superior vesicular artery, okay, and the second one is the obturator artery, and the third one is the inferior vesicular artery, fourth one is the middle rectal artery, and the fifth one is the internal pudendal artery, this one, internal pudendal artery, and sixth one is inferior gluteal artery, and the seventh one is superior gluteal artery. And then here in the image we are seeing the sacral nerves. Okay, so these are the branches coming from the anterior division. Then posterior division, one artery is the iliolumbar artery, right? Then lateral sacral artery, okay, lateral sacral, and one more branch coming from the posterior division is the superior gluteal artery. So this is the superior gluteal artery coming from the posterior division. So the obliterated umbilical artery, first one what we have seen is the it is a continuation of the internal iliac artery in the intrauterine life. So here we'll see the obliterated umbilical artery here, this one. So this is nothing but the continuation of the internal iliac artery in the intrauterine life, and it reaches in the intrauterine life it reaches to the placenta through the umbilical cord and conveys the deoxygenated fetal blood to the chorionic villi, and with the cessation of the placenta circulation after birth, the distal part of the umbilical artery is obliterated to form the corresponding medial umbilical ligament, and the proximal part remains patent as the superior vesicular artery. So the proximal part is patent as the superior vesicular artery, whereas the distal portion is obliterated. Okay, so the superior vesicular artery, it is derived from the non-obliterated part of the umbilical artery. Superior vesicular artery is derived from that, and this consists of 2 to 3 vessels. Superior vesicular arteries, 2 to 3 vessels are there, this one, this one, this one, all these are the superior vesicular arteries, and they supply the upper surface of the urinary bladder. Okay, and one vessel accompanies the vas deferens, one of these vessels it accompanies the vas deferens, it is not shown in this image, and supplies the vas deferens and reaches the testis through that, and there it anastomoses with the testicular artery. So one of the superior vesicular artery accompanies the vas deferens, supplies the vas deferens artery to the vas, what we say, and then it reaches the testis where it anastomoses with the testicular artery, and a few vascular twigs supply the terminal part of the ureter. Here where the ureter enters into the bladder, so there that junction near to the terminal, at that junction we will see the terminal part of the ureter. So that terminal part of the ureter is also supplied by the superior vesicular artery, right? So altogether, superior vesicle is supplying by 2 to 3 branches. It is supplying the superior surface of the urinary bladder. It is supplying the vas deferens, and it is anastomosing with the testicular artery, and it supplies the terminal part of the ureter. Right. So that is the superior vesicle artery. It arises from the non-obliterated part of the umbilical artery. Right. The obliterated portion of the umbilical artery is going to form the medial umbilical artery on the right side, and on the left side, lateral medial umbilical artery, left medial umbilical artery, right? The next branch is the inferior vesicle artery. So inferior vesicle artery, here if we see, this is the inferior vesicle artery, again coming from the anterior division of internal iliac. So it arises either separately or in common with the middle rectal artery. Okay, so this inferior vesicle arises either separately from the anterior division, or sometimes it arises as a common branch for the middle rectal, and supplies the base of the urinary bladder. So inferior vesicle artery is going to supply the base of the urinary bladder and also the terminal part of the ureter. It supplies along with this, it supplies the seminal vesicles. So here we'll see the seminal vesicles, right? So seminal vesicles, it also supplies the ampulla of the vas deferens and also the prostate. Okay, so inferior vesicle artery, it is going to supply the base of the urinary bladder, then it supplies the seminal vesicles, ampulla of the vas deferens, as well as it is supplying the prostate. We can see it here, right? So this inferior vesicle artery corresponds with the vaginal artery in the females, this artery, right? So this is the inferior vesicle artery. Now coming to the middle rectal artery. So middle rectal artery, this one, this is showing on the right side. This is the right middle rectal and this is the left middle rectal artery. So this middle rectal artery passes downwards and medially, here it passes downwards and medially through the pelvirectal space. Here between the rectum and the wall of the pelvis, this area is called as the pelvirectal space. So it passes through that space within the lateral ligaments of the rectum. This is the lateral ligament of the rectum. So through this, it supplies the lower part of the rectum, lower part of the rectum, and provides few twigs to the bladder and seminal vesicles also. The main supply is to the lower part of the rectum. In addition, it also supplies the urinary bladder as well as the seminal vesicles. So that is the middle rectal artery. Now coming to the obturator artery. So this is the obturator artery here, coming from the anterior division of internal iliac. So it passes forwards and downwards along the lateral pelvic wall, accompanied by the obturator nerve. Nerve is also there, which is not seen in this image. So it runs downwards and forwards in the lateral pelvic wall, and accompanied by the obturator nerve, which runs above the artery, and vein is below the artery. Okay, so above there will be nerve and below there is vein, right? And all these three structures, that is the nerve, artery and the vein, together they leave the pelvic cavity through the obturator foramen. This is the obturator foramen here. So they leave the pelvic cavity through this foramen or the obturator canal, and thereafter, in this image if we see, it has come out of the canal, and then it divides into an anterior branch and a posterior branch. Okay, anterior and posterior branches around the margin of the obturator foramen. This is the foramen, right? So here they together, the nerve, artery and the vein, they are leaving the pelvic cavity through this obturator canal, and here they have come out, and along the margins of the obturator foramen they have given two branches, anterior branch and a posterior branch, right? And when it is present within the pelvis, The obturator artery gives branches to the urinary bladder, and nutrient vessels are given to the ileum here. This is the ileum, so nutrient artery is given to the ileum, and a pubic branch is also given. So here this is the pubis, right? So when it is present within the pelvic cavity, that means before leaving through the obturator foramen, the obturator artery gives a branch to the urinary bladder, a nutrient branch to the ileum, and also to the pubis. Pubic branch is given, and the pubic branch, this pubic branch here, this is the pubic branch coming from the obturator artery, this one. Okay, so this anastomosis with the pubic branch of inferior epigastric artery, right? So here if we see, this is the inferior epigastric artery, which is a branch of external iliac artery, right? So this is the inferior epigastric artery, and that is giving a pubic branch like this. And this is the obturator artery, and this is also giving a pubic branch. So both these pubic branches, they anastomose with each other, and that forms an artery called as corona mortis. Okay, so in this image we can see it again. This one, this is the inferior epigastric artery giving the pubic branch, and this is the obturator artery giving the pubic branch. Both of them together, they are forming a artery called as corona mortis. So this, it is present in 20 to 30% of the cases. This anastomotic channel, okay, this becomes very prominent in 20 to 30% of the people, and forms an abnormal obturator artery. This is called as abnormal obturator artery, and which replaces the original artery. And so in that 20 to 30% of the cases, this artery will become more prominent, and in few cases it may replace this main artery. So then what happens, this artery might produce hazards in surgical approaches of the strangulated femoral hernia. Okay, so here because this has got variable relations with the femoral hernia, here in relation to this inguinal ligament, here we may see the femoral hernia here. So if it is strangulated, if the hernia is strangulated, that may cause, this abnormal artery may cause hazards. And also this should be kept in mind, this abnormal artery when it is present here, because this is the neurovascular bundle consisting of obturator nerve, artery and the vein. So this is leaving the obturator canal here, and here the head of the femur is forming the hip joint, right, with the acetabular cavity. So fracture of the neck of the femur, treating that, the surgical approach for treating the fracture neck of the femur, there also we should keep this abnormal obturator artery in mind. That's why it is called as corona mortis, this artery. Okay, right. The next artery is the uterine artery. So this uterine artery, it is now this one is the internal iliac or the hypogastric artery. So this artery is a large artery, large vessel in the female, and initially it accompanies the lateral side of the pelvic part of the ureter. This is the pelvic part of the ureter. So the artery is first lying lateral to the pelvic part of the ureter, and then on approaching the supravaginal part of the uterine cervix, so this is the uterine cervix. So on approaching this supravaginal part of the uterine cervix, the artery crosses above, right? It turns above and then passes upward, right? It passes above the ureter and also in front of the ureter. It comes to lie in front of the ureter once it reaches this level, and from lateral to medial side, and then passes upwards through the lower attached margin of the broad ligament of uterus. So here the broad ligament of uterus is there, right? So within that lower attached margin of the broad ligament, it is running upwards, and here the artery becomes tortuous, right? Tortuous, and it runs along the lateral margin of the body of the uterus, okay, supplying it, and it runs along the lateral margin of body of the uterus. Finally, it turns laterally here. Finally, it turns laterally and enters the ovary, okay, through the mesovarium and anastomosis with the ovarian artery. This is the ovarian artery. So here it reaches near the ovary, it enters the mesovarium. This is called as the mesovarium, right? So through that mesovarium, it is running towards the ovarian artery, and here the two arteries are getting anastomosed, right? And what does it supply? It supplies the urinary bladder, terminal part of the ureter here, in front of the uterus we are seeing the urinary bladder. So the uterine artery supplies the urinary bladder, terminal part of the ureter. It also supplies the vagina here, okay. The uterine artery gives off some branches to the vagina also, and it supplies the uterus. You can see all the branches supplying the uterus, and part of the uterine tube. This is the uterine tube. So some part of the uterine tube is supplied by the uterine branches. It also supplies the ovary through the anastomosis, and because it runs in the broad ligament, it supplies contents of the broad ligament also, right? So that is the uterine artery. So first it lies lateral to the pelvic part of the ureter, then it crosses from lateral to medial side and comes in front of the ureter, then runs upwards tortuously along the lateral border of body of the uterus. Then here it reaches the upper part of the body, running in the within the broad ligament of the uterus. Then it turns laterally, runs within the mesovarium, anastomosis with the ovarian artery, and supplies the urinary bladder, terminal part of the ureter, vagina, uterus, part of the uterine tube. It also supplies the ovary and also contents of the broad ligament of uterus. Then next artery is the vaginal artery. So this corresponds with the inferior vesical artery of the male, and this vaginal artery passes downwards and medially towards the vagina, and here it divides into several small branches. It is dividing into several small branches, and these branches anastomose in the midline, in front and behind the vagina. So these branches on either side, in front and also behind the vagina, they are anastomosing and form anterior and posterior azygous arteries of the vagina. And the vaginal artery supplies the vagina, the bulb of the vestibule, urinary bladder, and also the rectum. So all the structures in this vicinity, like the vagina, bulb of the vestibule, urinary bladder, and rectum, these are supplied by the vaginal arteries. Then the inferior gluteal artery. So here we can see this is the inferior gluteal artery. So it is one of the terminal branches of the internal iliac artery. Anterior division of internal iliac terminates into two branches. One terminal branch is this inferior gluteal artery. Okay. The artery passes downwards and backwards between the ventral rami of first and second sacral nerves. So this one, this is the S1 and this is the S2, or sometimes between S2 and S3. It runs in between either S1 and S2, the sacral branches, or between S2 and S3. And finally, it leaves the pelvis through the greater sciatic foramen. So here if you see, this is the greater sciatic foramen. Through that, it is leaving the pelvis and entering into the gluteal region, appears in the gluteal region. So this is the inferior gluteal artery. So here it is dipping down between S2 and S3. Then through the greater sciatic foramen, it is entering into the gluteal region here, right? So that is inferior gluteal artery. Then internal pudendal artery, another terminal branch of the anterior division, right? So this one is the internal pudendal artery. This is the inferior gluteal artery, right? And this one is the internal pudendal artery, which is the another terminal branch of the anterior division. So it leaves the pelvis, again this also leaves the pelvis through the greater sciatic foramen between piriformis and coccygeus muscles. Okay, between this is coccygeus and this is piriformis, in between them the pudendal artery is leaving the pelvis through this greater sciatic foramen. Okay, and the artery crosses the dorsal surface of the ischial spine, where so in gluteal region dissection, if you remember the pin structures, so internal pudendal artery is there. So it is related to the dorsal surface of the ischial spine, and medially it is related to pudendal nerve. So thereafter, after leaving the greater sciatic foramen, the artery enters the perineum through the lesser sciatic foramen. It enters into the perineum through the lesser sciatic foramen and passes forwards through the pudendal canal. Okay, so here the ischiorectal fossa will be there. So through the pudendal canal or Alcox canal, it enters into the lateral deep perineal pouch. Okay, and then it divides into its terminal branches. So all these are the terminal branches of the pudendal artery. So what are the two terminal branches? The two terminal branches of the pudendal artery are one is deep and the other one is dorsal artery of the penis. So this is the dorsal artery of penis and this is the deep artery of penis or clitoris in females. So these two are the terminal branches. One is dorsal artery of penis or clitoris, the other one is deep artery of penis or clitoris. These two are the terminal branches, right? Then the what are the other branches? One branch is the inferior rectal artery. So middle rectal was the branch of anterior division directly, and this is the inferior rectal artery, arises in the pudendal canal and traverses medially in arched manner across the ischiorectal fossa and supplies the structures in perianal region. So this inferior rectal artery supplies the structures in perianal region, right? Then one more branch is the perineal artery. This is the perineal artery. So this perineal branch arises in the anterior part of the pudendal canal and appears in the superficial perineal pouch. So this artery, perineal artery, is seen in the superficial perineal pouch by piercing the perineal membrane, and it divides into transverse perineal artery. One is the transverse perineal artery, and then two posterior scrotal or labial arteries, right? So these two are the posterior scrotal or perineal labial arteries. So it gives off one transverse branch. This is one transverse branch, and then it gives off two posterior scrotal or labial arteries. So that is the perineal artery. Then another one is the artery to the bulb of penis or vestibule in the deep perineal pouch. So that artery is not shown in this image. So artery to the bulb of penis or vestibule in the deep perineal pouch. It pierces the perineal membrane and supplies the erectile tissue of the bulb and corpus spongiosum of penis. So in this corpus spongiosum of the penis and bulb of vestibule and vagina in the female. So artery to the bulb of penis or vestibule is one more branch. Then urethral artery is also given off, pierces the perineal membrane and supplies the urethra up to the glans penis, right? So that is one more artery. And deep artery of penis, this one is the deep artery of penis or the clitoris. So this artery pierces the perineal membrane, enters the crus penis or crus clitoris to supply the erectile tissue of the corpus cavernosum. And one more last branch is the dorsal artery of penis or dorsal artery of the clitoris. So after piercing the perineal membrane, the artery passes upwards first, okay, between the crus penis or clitoris and the symphysis pubis. This is the symphysis pubis. So in between them it runs, between the crus penis or clitoris and then between the symphysis pubis, the artery runs upwards and then runs forwards between the two layers of the suspensory ligament of penis or clitoris. And in its further course, the artery lies beneath the fascia penis on the dorsum of the penis, where it is accompanied by dorsal nerve laterally and unpaired deep dorsal vein medially. So the artery is related to the vein and the nerve. And then what does it supply? It supplies the prepuce and glands and provides many circumferential branches around the facial sheath of the corpus cavernosum, all this area. So facial sheath of the corpus cavernosum, many branches are given to that. These branches anastomose with the deep artery. So the branches coming from the deep artery and the branches coming from the dorsal artery of penis or clitoris, they anastomose with each other to supply the corpus cavernosum and the sheath covering the corpus cavernosum, right? So these are the branches of internal pudendal artery. What are all the branches? One branch is the inferior rectal artery, then other one is the perineal artery, then artery to the bulb of penis or of the clitoris, of the vestibule, then urethral artery is given off, then deep artery of penis and dorsal artery of penis or clitoris. So these are the branches of pudendal, internal pudendal artery. So here it is present within the perineum, okay, piercing the perineal membrane. This is the perineal membrane. It is piercing the perineal membrane and it is entering into the perineal pouch, right? So this also supplies this vagina here, and also the perineal muscles, they are all supplied by this internal pudendal artery. Now coming to the posterior division of the internal iliac artery. So one important artery here is the iliolumbar artery. So this is the internal iliac artery here, and this one is the iliolumbar artery. Okay, this one is the iliolumbar artery. So as the name indicates, it supplies the ilium and it also reaches to the lumbar vertebrae, right? So it passes upwards and laterally in front of the ala of the sacrum, between the lumbosacral trunk and the obturator. So here if we see, lumbosacral trunk is this one, okay? So it is running between the lumbosacral trunk and the obturator nerve. Here there will be obturator nerve, which is not seen here. So this is running upwards and then divides into iliac and lumbar branches. Okay, so this is the iliac branch and this is the lumbar branch, supplying the ilium and the lumbar vertebrae. So the iliac branch passes beneath the psoas major. It passes beneath the psoas major and iliacus muscles, reaches the iliac fossa. So it has reached the iliac fossa and provides branches to the two muscles. Psoas major and iliacus are supplied by this iliac branch. And also it provides a nutrient branch to the ilium. What was the other artery that was supplying nutrient branch to the ilium? If you remember, just now we have discussed, is the obturator artery also gives a nutrient branch to the ilium, right? Then one more branch is the lumbar branch here. So this lumbar branch ascends through the substance of the psoas major and anastomoses with the fourth lumbar artery and sends a spinal branch through the intervertebral foramen between the fifth lumbar vertebra and the sacrum, right? This is the lumbar branch. So that is the iliolumbar artery. this one. Then superior gluteal artery. So superior gluteal artery, this one, this is the largest artery of the posterior division. And also the internal iliac artery. The superior gluteal artery is the largest branch of the internal iliac artery, passes backwards between the lumbosacral trunk and first sacral nerve. This is the first sacral nerve and this is the lumbosacral trunk. In between them, this superior gluteal artery will pass and leaves the pelvis through the greater sciatic foramen above the piriformis and appears in the gluteal region. So this is the piriformis muscle here. So below the piriformis, coming out through the greater sciatic foramen, it is the inferior gluteal artery. And above the piriformis, coming out through the greater sciatic foramen, this is the superior gluteal artery, which is the largest branch of the internal iliac artery. Now, the last branches of the posterior division are the lateral sacral arteries. So here if we see, this is the lateral sacral artery on both the sides, two arteries are there. Usually this lateral sacral consists of upper and lower branches, and the upper branch enters through the first or second pelvic sacral foramen. This is the upper branch. So through the pelvic sacral foramen they enter, and the lowest branch descends in front of the piriformis. So this is the piriformis here. So the lower one descends in front of the piriformis and sacral plexus of nerves along the lateral margins of the pelvic sacral foramen. So this point where you are seeing all these nerves, so they represent the sacral foramen. Through that the nerves are going out actually. So the arteries also accompany the nerves. And what do? They provide spinal branches through the pelvic sacral foramen, which supply the contents of the sacral canal, and finally emerge through the dorsal sacral foramen. Finally, they come out through the dorsal sacral foramen. So they supply the contents of the sacral canal. That's why we are calling them as lateral sacral arteries. So some clinical aspect related to the internal iliac artery. So transabdominal method with median or transverse incision is commonplace for internal iliac artery unilateral or bilateral ligation. So ligation is required whenever the pelvic surgeries are performed. So for that, however, in emergencies, there is a last resort of external method of approaching the internal iliac artery through the greater sciatic foramen. Using the superior gluteal artery, lateral sacral artery and obturator artery and piriformis muscle as the guides, this area through the greater sciatic foramen, the external approach is there to ligate the internal iliac artery. Then one more method is the bifurcation of the, see this bifurcation, it is like an inverted Y, and the branch coming off at right angles to the right angles to this abdominal artery like this. Okay, so this is at right angles. So that artery is the internal iliac artery or the hypogastric artery, and it courses medially and inferiorly to the palpating finger. And that's how by feeling the inverted Y and the artery branching off at 90 degrees, that's how again we can identify the internal iliac artery and ligate the artery, which is required in the pelvic surgeries. So let's just summarize the branches quickly. So the internal iliac is divided into an anterior division and a posterior division. Anterior division gives off obliterated umbilical artery and superior vesical artery, which comes out from the unobliterated part of the umbilical artery. Then inferior vesical artery, superior vesicular artery is going to supply the superior superior surface of the urinary bladder. Inferior vesicular artery is going to supply the base of the urinary bladder. It also supplies the ampulla of the vas deferens, seminal vesicles, and also the prostate. Then this is the middle rectal artery, which supplies the lower part of the rectum. Obturator artery. So obturator artery, one important clinical aspect we have discussed is the abnormal obturator artery, which is also called as corona mortis, which is dangerous in strangulated femoral hernias. Then uterine artery. So as the name indicates, it's going to supply the uterus, and along with the uterus, it also supplies the terminal part of the ureter, vagina, contents of the broad ligament. It also supplies the part of fallopian tube and ovary. So all these are supplied by the uterine artery. Then vaginal artery. So this corresponds with the inferior vesicular artery of the male, and this supplies the branches to the vagina. Anteriorly and posteriorly, they form a zygous system of arteries for the vagina to supply it anteriorly and posteriorly. Then inferior gluteal artery. It enters the gluteal region, passing through the greater sciatic foramen below the piriformis. Then this one is the internal pudendal artery. This again, it divides into many branches: inferior rectal artery, perineal branch, artery to the bulb of penis or vestibule, urethral artery, deep artery of penis or clitoris, and dorsal artery of penis or clitoris. These are the branches of internal pudendal artery. Then branches coming off from the posterior division, there are three branches. One is iliolumbar artery, other one is superior gluteal artery, and the last one is the lateral sacral arteries, right? So these are the branches of the internal iliac artery. So this slide again shows the same thing. Just for revising, you can go through this slide as well. Thank you.